talk, Alexis.
Not now, Mark. I'm late for the party and I have to get dressed.
Now, Alexis.
All right. Make it fast.
Well, I decided I'd leave Denver.
Oh?
Yes, what with that $100,000 gift of yours in my pocket, I can go where I want. But then I decided that I belong here with you.
What made you change your mind?
Dexter.
Look, I'm not in the mood for guessing games. What about him?
Well, he's through with you, Alexis. And you've got nobody else.
Your deep concern for me is overwhelming, but I've decided that I don't need a bodyguard anymore, so you're free to go tonight, if possible.
You may not need a bodyguard, but you need a man.
Do I?
Yes. You need me.
You must be suffering from delusions of adequacy.
You're going to pay for my silence, Alexis, with more than just money. From now on, we share everything, including your bedroom.
No. I paid you $100,000 to keep your mouth shut. For a tennis bum, that'll buy a lot of balls. And believe me, you're going to need them. Now, I want you to pack your bags and get out of here and out of Denver by the time I come back tonight. Otherwise, I'll have you carried out.
Kicking, screaming, feet first. You can't get rid of me, Alexis.
Watch me.
I'm sorry I was late, Mrs. Colby. There's some kind of accident around the corner. I had to take the long way around.
And I'm late for the party, Reed.
You know, it looks serious. Big crowd there, paramedics, and a fire truck and an ambulance just pulled up.
I heard the ambulance. I'm not deaf, but I am late.
Yes, Mrs. Colby. Alexis, I'm glad I caught you.
Well, I'm not glad, and I'm in a hurry.
This won't take long. I want to talk to you about money.
You and I have had all the talking that we are ever going to have in this life, Neal.